Good morning and welcome to Lake Highlands United Methodist Church. Welcome to our Church at Home edition. My name is Pastor Andy Roberts. I'm one of the associate pastors here, and our senior pastor, Jill Jackson-Sears, will be sharing the message just a little bit later this morning. And this is Palm Sunday, a wonderful time where we celebrate the coming of Jesus into Jerusalem on the very last week of his life. If you're joining us on Facebook Live or you're joining us on YouTube, we ask you to take a couple of moments just to greet one another in the comments today. Say hello to each other and share any prayer requests you might have. Just a few other announcements I want to share with you. We have Wednesday Night Live Prayer this coming Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. on Facebook Live, so we hope you'll join us for that, and you can email us any prayer requests that you might have. We also have daily devotions that are coming out from our staff every day of the week, and we hope those will be an encouragement to you. Those are following in line with our goal of reading the Bible together in 2020 to see Jesus clearly. We have a special email that will be coming out on Friday that will feature some special music from our traditional music as we remember the passion and suffering of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We also have lots of discipleship opportunities online for children and youth and adults, and you can contact Gretel at lhumc.com if you would like to learn more information about that. As I mentioned earlier, today we're celebrating Palm Sunday, and so you'll see in the course of this service, you'll see some pictures that many of our children and others in our church have received this week, waving palm branches, welcoming the presence of Jesus into their homes and into their lives. And so while we can't sing Hosanna together in person in a large gathering, we can certainly shout our Hosannas to the Lord in our homes, and we hope that you will do that. Your church is still here for you in this difficult time, and we want to serve you however we can. Because we're not able to gather physically on Sunday mornings and take up an offering, we want to encourage you to give online. And you can do that by going to lhumc.com/give. You can also write a check to our church. So we thank you in advance for your generosity. Would you join me in our call to worship? Rejoice greatly, O people of Zion. Shout in triumph, O people of Jerusalem. Look, your king is coming to you. He is righteous and victorious, and yet he is humble, riding on a donkey, even a donkey's colt. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. You are our God, and we will praise you. You are our God, and we will exalt you. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Let us pray together. Almighty God, on this day your Son, Jesus Christ, entered the holy city of Jerusalem and was proclaimed king by those who spread their garments and palm branches along his way. Let those branches be for us signs of his victory, and grant that we bear them in his name, may ever hail him as our Lord, and follow him in the way that leads to eternal life. In his name we pray. Amen.
Our scripture reading today comes from the Gospel of John, chapter 12, verses 12 through 19. I invite you to read along in your Bible, and if you are able, please stand for God's word. The next day, the great crowd that had come to the festival heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem. So they took branches of palm trees and went out to meet him, shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel." Jesus found a young donkey and sat on it, as it is written, "Do not be afraid, daughter of Zion. Look, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's colt." His disciples did not understand these things at first, but when Jesus was glorified, then they remembered these things that had been written of him and had been done to him. So the crowd that had been with him when he called Lazarus out of the tomb and raised him from the dead continued to testify. It was also because they heard that he had performed this sign that the crowd went to meet him. The Pharisees then said to one another, "You see, you can do nothing. Look, the world has gone after him." The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. You may be seated. Let us pray together. O Lord, you are our rock and our refuge. In you we find strength. May your Holy Spirit come and dwell among us. Even though we are physically far apart, we ask that you come near, that you open the scriptures to us, and that you transform our lives from the inside out, that we might be a reflection of your love and grace. We lift up this prayer in the holy name of Jesus, and all of God's people together say, Amen. Parades seem to be popping up everywhere these days. You see teachers decorating their cars and winding their ways through the neighborhoods of their students as a way of encouraging them in this new time. Apartment dwellers are singing from their balconies, serenading the first responders as they go in for their next hospital shift. Even people are dressing up in costume, maintaining social distance, but walking through their neighborhoods, offering joy and encouragement. Parades seem to be popping up everywhere. Today we remember a parade that took place hundreds of years ago, and the focal point was Jesus. As he entered into Jerusalem, the people were gathered, waving palm branches, shouting, "Hosanna!" And in a matter of days, they would be shouting, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" At this point, Jesus knew he was the Messiah. And he entered into Jerusalem on a donkey, which was more than just an act of humility. Jesus was paying attention to the details. He was paying attention to the details of what it meant for him to be the Messiah, and his action of entering into Jerusalem on a donkey was the fulfillment of prophecy to which John refers in his narrative, but I'm going to go back to this prophecy in the book of Zechariah, chapter 9, verse 9. Hear these words. "Rejoice greatly, O daughter Zion. Shout aloud, O daughter Jerusalem. Lo, your king comes to you, triumphant and victorious is he, humble and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey." See, Jesus chose to enter into Jerusalem on a donkey as a fulfillment of prophecy, so that you and I might know in these details who he is and what he came to do as our Savior. Jesus loves us through the details. He savored every moment. Throughout his ministry, as he entered into Jerusalem on a donkey, as he made his way towards the cross and the empty tomb, every step was intentional and purposeful so that you and I would know who Jesus is and how much he loves us. Jesus listened to God the Father. He paid attention to God's word. Every step was purposeful and intentional as he made his way to the cross, thinking about us and his love for us with every step that he took. Now, in looking at the details that were important to Jesus on this journey, it's also important for us to look at the details that were not important to Jesus. If the people on that parade were expecting a great king entering into the Jerusalem with trumpet blast and pomp and circumstance, Jesus was not worried about that detail. If the crowd was looking for a great warrior that would overthrow the Roman Empire, Jesus was not concerned about that detail. If the people were looking for a very particular kind of Messiah that fit within their very restricted definition, Jesus was not concerned about that detail. The only details that Jesus was concerned with was being obedient to his Father and showing his great, great love for all of the world. Those were the details that mattered to Jesus. But I think sometimes it's easy for us to forget. We forget this detailed, deep love that Jesus has for you and me and for the whole world. I was reminded of this just this last week. I've been going out for a lot of walks. I just need to get out of the house. I don't know about you, but with three kids and a husband, the walls in our house seem to be just kind of closing in. Tell me I'm not the only one here. And so I go out for these daily walks, and as I was walking, I was so caught up in my worries and my fears and the uncertainties of the future, and my head was just spinning. And I looked over, and I see this bird bathing in a puddle, shamelessly bathing in a puddle. I thought to myself, have you not heard of social distancing? But then in that same thought came the promise that just as God is providing for that bird with a bath and a puddle, so God is still providing for us today in the details of our lives. The challenge is, it's so easy for us to forget that. We get so caught up in our worries and concerns and our futures, and we fail to see the detailed blessings that God is providing in this very moment. I mean, think about the miracle that we're able to worship together today through the miracle of technology. We are the body of Christ, virtually. And while it would be better to be together face to face, God has given us the gift of technology to be able to do this. I also think about our discipleship groups, who are still meeting on Sunday mornings and Sunday night. I mean, even last week, I was teaching confirmation class, and I want to show you a picture because this is just the most precious thing to me. And I never thought that I would be teaching confirmation class in this way, but here we are. And they are all there every Sunday, still learning, still growing, still strengthening their faith. And I think about the blessing of our church. I mean, we've established years of caring for our neighbors who are materially poor, and that has not changed. And so we still provide food. But it's more than food, it's hope. It looks like pasta and fruit and a can of green beans, but to the people who receive it, it is our way of saying, God loves you. We love you. God has not forgotten you. We have not forgotten you. God still loves you in the details. And so I would encourage you today to reflect on the Jesus details of your life. How is God calling you to live in this time? Because I think it has very little to do with worries and concerns, although those are very real. I think it has more to do with loving God with all of our heart, mind, soul, strength, and loving our neighbor as ourselves. So what are the Jesus details in your life? Write them down. Put them in a place where you can see them every day. And think about how we can shift our mindsets, our prayer lives, our actions to reflect the things that truly matter, the Jesus details of our life. Because Jesus loved us in the details. Every step that he took through the palms in his entry into Jerusalem, all the way to the cross and the empty tomb, he was thinking about you and me all of the way. And Jesus still loves us in the details of our lives. He still provides for us. So may our lives reflect the detailed, deep love that Jesus has for us, so that all people in Lake Highlands and beyond can know that love. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Would you join me in a time of prayer as we pray for our church and we pray for those around us? I'll share a specific group of people, and you can take some time to pray silently in your own homes. Together, let us pray for the people of Lake Highlands United Methodist Church. Let us pray for those who suffer and for those who are in trouble. Let us pray for the concerns of the Lake Highlands community or wherever you live. Let us pray for the world, for its leaders and its peoples. Let us pray for the worldwide church, its leaders, its members, and its mission. Let us pray for the communion of saints, those who are still with us and those who have gone on to glory. Now let us join together praying the prayer Jesus taught us as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna. up to take their place. The selfless faith, the selfless faith. I see a near revival stirring as we pray and seek. We're on our knees, we're on our knees. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highlands. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Come on, one last time, sing it with me.
Hosanna, Hosanna. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
We continue our journey with Jesus as he makes his way to the cross and the empty tomb. Hear these words from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 15, verses 12 through 20. Pilate spoke to them again. "Then what do you wish me to do with a man you call the King of the Jews?" They shouted back, "Crucify him." Pilate asked them, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Crucify him." So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas for them, and after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified. Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, that is, the governor's headquarters, and they called together the whole cohort. And they clothed him in a purple cloth, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him. And they began saluting him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down in homage to him. After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloth and put on his clothes, and they led him out to crucify him.
Oh. times he saved.